Hello, dear students. Today we are covering topic writing for and against essay. What is for and against essay? An essay on the advantages and disadvantages of some current issue. A formal piece of writing in which a topic is considered from opposing points of view. You should present both sides in a fair way by discussing them objectively and in equal detail. So here are some points to consider. First of all, make a list of the points for and against. Start each paragraph with a topic sentence which summarizes the topic of the paragraph. Do not use informal style like conjunctions, colloquial language, or strong language to express your opinion. For example, I know. Use quotation, rhetorical questions, or direct address to the reader in the introduction to grab their attention and make your composition more interesting. So here's the structure. An introductory paragraph in which you clearly state the topic to be discussed without giving your opinion. A main body in which the points for and against, along with your justification, examples, or reasons are presented in separate paragraphs. A closing paragraph in which you give a balanced consideration of the topic and state your opinion. So let's quickly overview the structure. So the first comes introduction, then paragraph one, topic sentence about advantages, and then supporting statement one with the arguments and examples, then supporting statement two with the arguments and examples, then paragraph two, the topic sentence for the disadvantages of the issue, and then supporting statement one with arguments and examples, supporting statement two with the arguments and examples, and at the end the conclusion. So here's several useful linking words and expressions to use in for and against list. Say the first is to list points. Firstly, first of all, in the first place, to begin or to start with. Secondly, thirdly, finally. To list advantages, one, another, a further, an additional major advantage of this, the main or greatest or first advantage of this. To list the disadvantages, one another, a further, an additional disadvantage, drawback, the main or the greatest or the most serious or the first disadvantage or the drawback of, another negative aspect of. To introduce points or arguments for and against, one very convincing point, argument in favor of or against, a further common criticism of. It could be argued, often claimed, suggested that. It's widely argued, maintained, generally felt, believed, held that. Some, many, most people, experts, scientists, skeptics, critics claim or suggest or argue. Feel, maintain, believe, point out, agree, hold, support, the view that, oppose that, the view that, are in favor of or are in favor against. Are of the opinion that convinced that are supposed to add more points to the same topic. So you can use in addition to this, furthermore, moreover, besides, apart from, what is more, as well as, to mention the fact, also, not only, but also, as well as, both this and there is another side, the issue, question, argument of. To make contrasting points. On the other hand, however, still, yet, but, nonetheless, nevertheless, even though, it may be said, argued, claims that others, many people oppose this. Viewpoints strongly disagree. Claim, feel, believe in this argument incorrect, misguided, also, though, even though, while, least, whereas, despite, in spite of, the fact or that, regardless of that fact that. Opponents of this argue or believe that or claim that the fact that contradicts the belief idea that while it's true to say that in fact that to introduce examples for example for instance such as like in particular particularly especially this is clearly illustrated or shown by the fact one a clear striking the typical example of this the fact that shows or illustrates that. To emphasize the point, clearly, obviously, it's obvious, naturally, of course, needless to say, indeed. To express reality, in fact that of the matter is actually in practice, it's fact that in effect. To make general statements, as a general rule, generally, in general, on the whole, by and large in most cases. To make partially correct statements, to a certain extent or to a certain degree, to some extent or degree, in way, sense, this is partly true, but to a limited extent, there is some truth in this, in some cases up to the point. To explain or clarify a point, in other words, that is to say this, which means that, to express cause owing to, due to, the fact that, on account of, on the ground that, given that, because, as, since. To express effect, therefore, such as thus, as a result, consequences, consequently, so to, for the reason, if were to happen, the effect, result would be. To express the intention, to, so as to, in order to, so that, with the intention of. So after this, you have to use ing form of the verb. Useful expressions and linking words or phrases. Conclusion, expressing balance and consideration in your opinion. So in conclusion, it can be said or claimed that, on balance, it seems appears that, all things, it would seem that, consider it, it's likely or unlikely or possibly that, taking everything into account or consideration, or to conclude, there is no doubt that, it's true to say that, to some, although it must be said that, all in all, or finally, lastly, it may be concluded, said that. So these kind of phrases and word expressions can be used in order to conclude your essay. It's my belief, opinion that, I firmly believe or feel, think that, I'm convinced that, I'm inclined to believe that, I do not agree that with, so to express your own opinion. Write an essay of 200-250 words. So your essay must have an introduction, body and conclusion in the topic. Some people say that international sports events bring countries closer, while others say that there is cause problems between countries. Discuss both these views and give your opinion. So let's quickly overview the sample introduction. An adequate introduction contains one general statements about the subject that provide the background for. Second, the thesis statement which names the specific topic and the main ideas or major subdivision of the topic. So here's an example. Sports events like the Olympics and FIFA World Cup arouse global interest. By sport is all about competition. So do these events unite countries because of a shared interest in sport or divide them because of opposing interest in the result? So here you can see the conclusion. An adequate conclusion contains one, a summary of the main points, second, a final opinion, and here you can see the example. In conclusion, international sports event can help people learn more about the countries. However, national supporters may see opposing teams and their countries as enemies. Personally, I think that there will be an element of war in international sports events. So, dear students, today we have covered the structure of for and against essay. Please try to use this in your practicum and try to make one essay in the topic given today. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye.